Hey guys, I just wanted to wish everyone a very happy Mother's Day. To all the mothers out there, regardless of whether your children are of the plant variety or of the fur variety, I want you to take today and really enjoy all of your children. Today should be relaxing and de-stress. De-stress before we head into yet another crazy week. I haven't had much time to upload all of the progress that my babies have been having over the past few weeks. It's been gorgeous in Seattle. It feels like summertime. Everybody's in their shorts, getting their base tan before the summer really hits us. So yeah, I can't wait to upload those videos here in the next few days. But I did get a chance to stop by the plant nursery a few times over the last couple of weeks, and so I wanted to share with you guys the plants that I bought recently. I was watching one of, I forget his name, Nick. I think you guys know what I'm talking about, but I was watching one of his videos, and he showed his string of hearts that just grew feet, I think, in a matter of less than a year. And so ever since I watched that video, I've been desperate to get my hands on one of these string of hearts. And I finally found one at my favorite local hardware store for a few bucks. So yeah, it's labeled here as a rosary vine, but I've heard it often referred to as a string of hearts. And it's not looking too full right now, but that's because it's just a little baby. And oh, I'm sorry, I got it for $4.99. Not bad. And it's already grown. I've had this now for a few weeks, and it's already grown quite a bit. There's lots of new growth on there, so I'm very excited to get this to grow longer. I put it in one of the white small pots, but it seems to be a little bit big for this one, so I might move it. I'm not sure, but I love the way the heart-shaped leaves look against the white ceramic pod. It looks really good. So maybe I have a little bit of a bigger one that I can stick this in. And next, I don't know if you guys have seen my houseplant tour videos, but I used to have a maidenhair fern, and that died in a matter of a few weeks. So this one is a maidenhair vine, and so I don't know if it's gonna be as difficult or finicky as the maidenhair fern, but I noticed that this has already gotten a little bit crispy, so it does like to be watered more often than my other plants. But yeah, I really liked how this looked. I like the it reminds me, it's very mystical? I don't know if that's the right word, but she's very delicate. I mean, after, you know, I filmed this little piece, I noticed that there were already a ton of things on the floor. And so, oh yeah. So a lot of you guys ask me, how do I use the pots that don't have the drainage holes? And that's just what I do. I just put some rocks in there. I literally have one of those big rocks from the from Lowe's that you can get for $5, and I stick it downstairs in my basement kitchen sink, and I just pick a few rocks at a time whenever I have a new pot that I need to use. So yeah, it works excellent. It's not the best because you do need to dump out the excess water every now and then, but it works. Yeah, so here's one of my beautiful new children and one of my old children. I finally got my hands on a marble queen pothos. I love this devil's ivy plant. My other ones aren't doing too well. I got this like fungusy, yellowish, like circle looking fungus on one of my old ones, so that one I'm nursing back to health. But look at this, one of the leaves is like straight up half green and half white. I think this looks so beautiful. I was so happy when I found this. And so this is one of my this is another fern that I got from this place called Mulbax up in North King County, or is it Snohomish County? I'm not sure. But yeah, it was a dollar a dollar something. So I had to get it. You know, I have very bad luck with ferns. But for $1.99, it looks so pretty. And this apparently is a water plant. Like if you have an aquarium, these are one of the plants that you would use to have in your underwater ecosystem. But I don't have one of those. So this is just gonna go by the window, and let's hope for the best for this. I don't really know much about those plants, so let's move on. This is such a pretty plant. I wasn't quite sure what it was called, but I did a little bit of research online, and it's apparently called a caricature plant, probably because of the watercolor-ish pattern on its leaves, but it's so pretty and beautiful. I can't wait. Oh, nosy. I can't wait till that plant grows a little bit more. This next one is so beautiful. Look at the red stems in contrast to the variegated white and green pattern on its leaves. This is so beautiful. If you haven't already seen my other videos, you can tell I have a strong affinity for ivy-like plants. So I love this. I noticed it had some spider mites when I took it home, so I just sprayed it with soapy water, and I haven't seen any spider webs since. So hopefully that took care of that. But yeah, if you live in Washington and haven't been to this place, Molbax, it's so freaking huge. My husband took me on a nursery adventure day a couple weeks ago, and we visited a few huge nurseries. I really regret not taking my camera because it would have been great to show you guys. Here's one of my fur babies. He's so cute. He's so nosy too. He loves just sticking his little cute little furry face with anything that I'm up to. But anyway, so I've been wanting to get a philodendron for the longest time, and it's funny because these are really common houseplants, but yet I could never seem to get my hands on one. So I finally saw one at McClendon's, which I love going to for all of my houseplants. Oh, by the way, I saw recently that they had those Pilea peperomioids, you know, that were really big at one point on Instagram. They had those for $17.99. I was kind of kicking myself because my husband bought me one for like 40 bucks. And so, yeah, I felt really bad. But anyway, that's where they have them. They're really great. And that's where I got this from. So this Stramanthe, when I went to one of the big nurseries, I think it was like Flower World up in Snohomish, they had a ton of these, and I really wanted to get one, but my husband was all like, oh, it's too big, you already have all these plants. But I really, really wanted one, and I just kept thinking and kicking myself about this because I didn't get it. But then when I went to McClendon's, they had one left. One, guys, this was meant to be. This was so meant to be, and so I snagged it because I'm like, I couldn't stop thinking about this plant. It's so freaking beautiful. Look at the deep magenta. And no, that's not just the camera. It is magenta in person. It's so beautiful. Anyway, guys, so sorry to just talk your ear off in this plant haul video, but I haven't talked to anyone in the past 2 weeks. Just kidding. When I say anyone, I mean you guys on YouTube. And it's not like you guys really talk back, except for in the comments. So if you enjoyed this video or have any other tips or just anything you want to say, leave a comment below. And if you're new to my channel, please subscribe so you won't miss any of my chattiness in the future uploads. Okay, guys, thank you so much again. Till next time.